Hi folks, my name is Luis Iberrocal, and in this episode I'm going to show you how to use Model Builder to automate an analysis using ArcGIS 10.6. Now, if you'd like to follow along the tutorial, you can find the data at bit.ly/LuisIberrocal_selection. This tutorial is based on the previous tutorial I did, and it's already on YouTube. I'm going to show you the link down in the description. But what we want is to raise money to build a free meal center for people of low income. The idea is to help as many communities as possible that are as close as possible. We have determined that the radius between communities will be 2.5 kilometers, and we want to help communities with more than 250 people where an average income is less than $150. Now, we came up with 2.5 kilometers because I had already built the model and I tested several distances. So I'm going to show you how to build that model in order to do this analysis several times without doing it manually. In order to create our model, first thing we need to do is create a toolbox to save the geoprocessing model inside. So we're going to go to catalog, I'm going to right click on my geodatabase. I'm using a file geodatabase. I'm going to right click, go to new toolbox, and I'm going to name it underscore towns in need. I use the underscore so it will show at the top of the Arc toolbox and I won't have to hassle trying to find it. Then I'm going to go to Arc toolbox. I'm going to right click over Arc toolbox. I'm going to add toolbox. I'm going to add towns in need. Open. Now I have it here. We're now going to start creating our geoprocessing model. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to click Model Builder. I'm going to click here. And I'm going to do a save. And I'm going to look for my toolbox, which is towns in need. And I'm going to call my model towns in need. Save. Our first operation in the model is to select from Coclet towns the towns we're interested in. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to select, use the tool select layer by attribute, and we're going to drag and drop it into our model. We're going to double click on select by attribute, and we're going to select the source, the layer name or table view, which is Coclet Towns. I want a new selection, and I'm going to give here the query I have already. So I'm going to load it from a file I had already saved. And as you can see here, what I want is ingreso promedio, which is average income, to be less than 150, and personas, which is people in Spanish, with more than 250. I want these towns to be selected. So I'm going to do OK. I'm going to apply. OK. Now, as you can see here, it has created the selection here. I'm going to rename this so it'll be a little bit clearer for me. I'm going to rename it to selection. Do OK. Our next operation is to copy our selection into a new feature class. For that, we're going to use the copy features tool. We're going to drag and drop it here. I'm going to double click on copy features, and I'm going to tell them what's my input feature. My input feature would be selection, which I want. I'm going to leave the default feature class output, and I'm going to keep the rest of the configuration just as it comes. Click OK. Now, as you can see, it has connected copy features with selection. I'm going to rename this. I'm going to call it towns in need. OK. Make it a little bit bigger so it'll be easier to read. Our next operation is buffering. So we're going to look up buffering. Here we have buffer. and the analysis tool, and we're going to drag and drop it here. And we're going to double click on buffer. We're going to select our input feature, which would be towns in need. I'm going to use 2,500 as my distance. I'm going to site type full and type round. I'm going to keep the method on planner, and I'm going to choose dissolve all. I'm going to apply. Okay. I'm going to rename the output of the buffer. I'm going to right click over it, and I'm going to click on rename, and I'm going to name it towns in need buffer. Click OK. Now, I want my model towns in need to be able to use different distances. So instead of hard coding the distance, I'm going to set it as a variable. I'm going to right click over buffer, make variable from parameter. I'm going to choose distance. Click. Now, what you're going to see later is when I run this, it's going to ask me the distance I want to use for the buffer. The buffer tool creates a feature class as a multi-part feature class. So now what we need to do is change it from multi-part to single part. For that, we're going to use multi-part to single part tool. Drop it here, we're going to double click on it, and we're going to select towns in need buffer. Click apply. Okay. And we're going to rename the output to buffer single part. Our next step is to do a spatial join in order to get the data from towns in need into our buffer single part. We're going to use spatial join, drag and drop right here. Double click on spatial join. For target features, we're going to use our buffer single part. And for our joins, we're going to use towns in need, because we want the data from towns in need to go into a single part buffer. We're going to do a join one to many. We're going to keep all target features, and we're going to keep our match option as intersect. I do OK. And we're going to rename our output as buffer spatial join. Okay. Our model is starting to look a little bit messy with these lines going over each other. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on the line and move it like so. This is just for looks purposes. It will not affect how the tool works or anything, but this makes it a little bit more easier to read. So I'm going to click here, push it here, click here, click here. And then if I want to drag, as you can see, when I get into one of the vertexes, I can adjust it a little bit more, maybe something like this. Our next step is to do a dissolve in order to get our data summarized. So we're going to drag and drop dissolve from the data management toolbox. We're going to double click here. Our input feature is going to be buffer spatial join. We're going to use as the dissolve field the target FID, and the statistics fields we want to use are ING prom, which is average income. I selected here. We're going to, the statistic type we want is a sum, so I light them up for us. Then we're going to use personas, which is people. Click here, you'll find it for me. The statistic type for personas is sum. And we're going to do a count on código, which is the code for the town. Select on it. And we're going to do a count for count. We're going to keep create multiple features optional, checked in, and the unsplit lines blank. I'm going to do OK. We're going to rename my output as summary. Now we need to add two fields. We're going to start by the per capita income. We're going to do add field from the data management toolbox. We're going to drag and drop it here. We're going to double click on add field. And as input table, we're going to choose summary. We're going to name our field per capita income. We want it to be a double. We're going to keep all the others as default, all the other values as default, and we're going to do OK. Now we're going to do another add field. I'm sorry, I need to pick it up from the data management. I'm going to do add field here. I'm going to pick it up from Claytown's copy feature. We're going to make this index. And we're going to use double. The rest we keep as default, values. We're going to do OK. Now we're going to calculate the fields we just added. For that, we're going to use the tool called Calculate Field from Data Management. I'm going to drag and drop it here. We're going to double click on it. And I'm going to select as input table, summary complete. And I'm going to choose the field I want to calculate, which would be per capita income. And I'm going to use the expression. And my per capita income is the sum of the average income divided by the sum of personas, of how many people there are. I click OK. OK. Now I need to calculate my index. Drag and drop here, calculate. I'll select this input table, my previous, the one I just calculated, and I'm going to choose the field I want to calculate, which would be index, and the expression would be per capita income times count of code. So I'm multiplying the per capita income against how many towns are inside the polygon. Click OK. Okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to run the model. Before we do that, I want to declare the final results as a model parameter. So you'll ask when I run the model for this parameter, and I'm going to do the add to display. So when the model finishes running, it'll add it to my table of content. I'm going to click here to do run. Now, as you can see, it has finished and it added final results to my table of content here. Now, before I run my model from my toolbox, I always like to clean up, make sure everything is okay. So I'm going to run here, delete intermediate data, which will delete all the data that it's intermediate before final results, and I'm going to run validate entire model. So it will not run the selection again, so the selection will be clean. Now, the last thing I need to do is add this as a model parameter. So I'm gonna right click on it and model parameter. I'm gonna do save here. I'm going to close it. Now, I'm gonna double click on here. Now you can see it asking me what's the name of my final result feature class. I'm gonna name mine towns in need 1500, because I'm going to use a buffer 1500 meters. Here I'm going to select 1500 meters. Okay, that's running. As you can see, I did three runs with the tool, one for 1500 meters, one for 2500 meters, and one for 3000 meters. And this is the result. If you like my videos, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thank you very much.